Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you all might be fine and studying for your test. So, children, today in grammar, we are going to read chapter 19 about the adverbs, and today in that we will discuss about the adverb of place. In the previous class, we have read about adverbs and adverb of manner. So, what is an adverb? Let us recall. So, adverb is a word that is more about a verb. Word that is more about a verb or the action word, that is adverb. An adverb of manner does how the action was done. Now, here adverb of place will tell where the action is being done or has been done. So, the word expresses place is called adverb of place. So, the word that will tell you about where the action happens or the place of happening, that is adverb of place. It is used to explain where an action happens. An adverb of place don't usually end in ly. We have read about the adverb of manner that they usually ended in ly, but adverb of place don't usually end in ly. And when you ask the question where, you will get the answer of where the action was done. Now, adverb of place are here, there, everywhere, nowhere, up, within, out, in, backward, away, down, left, close by, back, inside, far and near, near, nearby, inside, outside, upstairs, around, under, onward, upward, forward, below, behind, etc. So, these are the words which denote the adverb of place, and they can be used in the sentence. Let us understand. Now see here. Sam sees many puppies outside. So what is action word? What is a verb over there? Action word. And it is describing where Sam sees many puppies. So where he has seen? He has seen it. And them outside. So outside will become adverb of place, because it tells where the action was done. Now adverb of place with more examples. We should wait here for more instruction. We should wait here for more instructions. Here modifies the verb wait. So wait, here it tells more about the verb wait. Where should we wait? We should wait here. The statue was knocked over by the child. So, where was the statue knocked? It was knocked over by the child. A small kitten looked around for its mother. So, where did the small kitten look around? So, it looked around. Sorry, where did the small kitten look? So, it looked around for its mother. So, around is the adjective that modifies the word looked. So, verb is a verb, looked is a verb here. In one area, the sheep were lying about. So, about modifies the verb lying. Then, let us understand. Adverb of place. Now, see, don't be confused with the adverb of place and preposition. It is easy to confuse with adverb of place with a preposition. So, if the word is a preposition, it must be followed by a noun. So, you have to keep in mind that if it is a preposition, how you will differentiate? If it will be a preposition, it will be followed by a noun. That means there will be preposition and afterwards there will be noun. Let us understand it. See, word is by. Adverb of place, we will use that by in adverb of place. His mother stopped by. Now, how you will know that it is a preposition? His mother lives by the lake. Now, here what do we see? Lake is a noun. By is followed by noun, by the lake. Okay. So, here this by will become a preposition because there is a noun after by. Now, the soccer player fell down. So, here down is adverb of place. The hiker slowly walked down the mountain. Now, after down, what do we see? We see mountain, and we know that mountain is a noun, is a common noun. So, that down will represent preposition here. Then, She turned around and walked the other way. Now she walked around the corner to her destination. In the first sentence, around tells about adverb or place. And in the second, around tells about a preposition because it is followed by the noun, the corner. Now, the teacher warned the students not to fall behind. So, what is behind here? Behind is adverb of place in this sentence. Then, in the next sentence, let us see. The cat lost its toy behind the sofa. Now, sofa, you know that it is a noun. And this behind is followed by sofa. The cat lost its toy behind the sofa. So that here behind will become preposition in the second sentence, and in the first sentence that is adverb because it is not followed by a noun. Now children, we will read about adverbs of time. So adverbs of time tells us when an action happened, and it also tells us for how long and how often the action takes place. So the word that will tell you how the action happens, when the action happens, that is adverb of time. Now, where to place the adverbs? When adverbs are usually at the end of the sentence, they can be before the sentence also, children. Let us see with example. Juan Manuel attended to the seminar yesterday. Here yesterday, it is adverb of time because when we ask when data, Juan Manuel attended the seminar, then you can say that he attended the seminar yesterday. So it tells about the time. I will visit her tomorrow. So I will visit her tomorrow. When will I visit her? I will visit her tomorrow. That also tells you about the time. When you ask the question, when you get the answer. Now see here. My father came home early. Now what is the action word or the verb here? Here you have came as the action word, and this early describes when my father came. So he came home early. So here early is adverb of time. So adverbs of time describes when things happen. We have read this. They are usually placed at the beginning or the end of the sentence. Adverbs of time talk about the past, present and future. Afterwards, now, soon, then, yesterday. So they tell about present, past and future. You know that time is can be in the past, time can be in the present, time can be in the future. We have read about the tense. Now see, in the past. Yesterday, ago, the day before, last week, last month, last year. They tell about the time which has passed, adverb of time. When, while, still, yet, today, now, this tells you about the present time. Okay, adverbs of time in the present. Soon, then, tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, later, tells you about the future. Okay, adverbs of time in the future. So, already, finally, before, after, eventually, they can be discussed. Used to discuss past, present and future. So children, this you will learn nicely. Now see, adverbs of time, when. Today, yesterday, later, now, last year tells you about the adverb of time. Then for how long. All day, not long, for a while, since last year. Then how often. Sometimes, frequently, never, often, yearly. They tell us about the adverb of time. That I go there sometimes, or I visit to my friend's house sometimes. I come here frequently. I will never go there. There also you can see. Then my friend comes to my home often. Then this type of sentences you can make, and then you can understand that these are the adverbs of time. Okay, children. So, thank you. You will learn all the adverbs properly and do your homework nicely. So goodbye, take care, and revise for your exam properly.